I screwed over 40 RVers, and I am so sorry. Coming right up, I will explain. Hey there, how are you? Dr. Dave, the RV dummy, back at you, and I have a tremendous apology because I put these videos out. I've been doing this for several years now, and my goal is to help all RVers, whether you're new, whether you've been RVing for a long time, whether you're thinking about getting an RV, whether you're just curious about the whole community. And my goal was to put out positive videos to help all of you. Well, I think I screwed up last week. Well, maybe not screwed up, but maybe somehow put a jinx on a lot of you. Because so many of you got back to me after I did that video a couple videos ago about 10 types of people or groups that you do not want to camp next to or near. That, by the way, they got a lot of recognition and a lot of great comments, and I really do appreciate that. But, and I listed 10 types of situations you do not want to get yourself into at a campground. And a lot of you watched it. A lot of you took it to heart and hopefully took the advice. But right after I did that video, I almost immediately, within the next several days, got 4 comments from people that claim that I totally jinxed them as they were at a campground right after that video came out. Now, in my experience from doing videos and from speaking and from doing emails and things like that, if 4 people took the time to write into me to tell me that I jinxed them, that usually there are at least 10 times that many that will just not write in but have the same feeling. Like something happened to them, but not everybody likes to take the time to email or comment. It's just because it's a hassle. So by my calculation, even though 4 of you wrote in, and I'll tell you these stories right now, you're not going to believe it, but I'm guessing at least 40 people are in the same situation. And to those 40 of you, 40 plus or minus, I sincerely apologize. The first person that wrote into me and said it was the RV Rookie. And by the way, if you're not watching her channel, you got it. She's a friend of mine. She's a full-time RVer in a Class C, and you got to check it out. Just do a search for RV Rookie. She will come up. But she told me that as soon as she finished watching the video, she's at a campground, and she had maybe a bit of a central location, which is a mistake in my mind. If you watch that video, you'll see why I say that. She said, within minutes, several different RVs showed up, pulled into the campground, pretty much surrounding her, with all the campsites surrounding her. And here she is in the middle of this whole, I don't know whether it's like a neighborhood or family reunion or gathering, but she's like smack in the middle and people are running across her campsite. She said it was a mess. And she said, Dr. Dave, thanks a lot. You jinxed me. Well, RV Rookie, again, I am so sorry. I did not mean to jinx anybody. I'm meaning to give powerful information. And the fact that happened to you, I just feel really, really bad. But if you do remember from the video, I did say, stay away from those central locations because they can be dangerous. So you'll remember that from now on. Also, Outdoor Nomad, Steve. By the way, he's got a great channel as well. Check out, just do a search for Outdoor Nomad here on YouTube. He does some really good videos, mainly from parks, and gives like a really good, sometimes walking history of like what it's going. He's very, very interesting, and he's a good guy. He's actually the guy that drove my original Class B van across the country. I bought it in California. He's a retired truck driver, and he did me a tremendous favor and drove it all the way from California when I was living in Maryland. But Outdoor Nomad told me as soon as this video came out, he's camping. In fact, I think he said he was on BLM land, like public land somewhere. It wasn't even like a real campground. And another rig pulled up fairly close. He's actually doing, I think he's camping out of his car with a tent, I believe. Or a hammock or something like that. So rig pulls up fairly close. They very polite. It's an elderly couple. They say, do you mind if we camp here? And he said, you know, he's looking at them and they're older and he knows they're going to be very quiet. So he said, oh, sure, that's no problem. Right there is fine. Seconds later, you got to be careful with this. Because everybody would think an elderly couple, totally safe. Seconds later, the grandkids come piling out of the RV, and Steve was screwed because he said they were noisy, They were running around his campsite. It was just a disaster. So, Steve, again, I am humbly apologizing to you if I jinxed you from my last video as well. That sounds awful. I don't know what I would have left, probably. I mean, I guess you can't say to them, you can camp here only if you don't have little kids running around. But the grandkids were, I mean, they were being grandkids. They were being kids, which kids do. But we don't want to be camping around noisy kids. At least I don't, and many of you don't. Look, again, I love kids. I've had kids. I've been through all those stages. My kids are older and married now. I don't want to be dealing with young kids screaming near me when I'm trying to be peaceful. That's all. Full tiny house. Also said that she was camping and a barking dog happened to show up. I guess a family with a barking dog that would not stop barking the entire time. And coincidentally, right after I did the video and said, please be careful, stay away from dogs. I love dogs too, but barking dogs, I don't want to be near them. So full tiny house, I'm sorry it happened to you, and I'm starting to feel responsible for these situations that you all got into immediately after I did this last video. Martin, a guy named Martin Barr, messaged me, and he said, what did he say? A family in a travel trailer pulled up and set up camp, and that's okay. But he said they pulled up at 10 p.m. in the evening, and they're just getting started. Everybody's going to sleep or else sitting around a peaceful campfire. It's dark, and a large family in a travel trailer pulls up. You know what they've got to do? They've got to start setting up camp, leveling, setting up eating. He said it was a disaster. He said it was ridiculous. And you know, I know there are rules and there are curfews, but you know, it's a very difficult thing and confrontational to go up to a family that just shows up because they're probably working hard. I'm just guessing. Let's say it's a Friday afternoon. They got off work. They're coming to camp. It's very difficult, even though, yeah, there might be a curfew, but it's hard to go up to a family and say, hey, it's after curfew. Shut up. But we just got here. Shut up. It just puts us in a really tough situation. So Martin, again, I am so sorry. I jinxed four of you that wrote in. Times 10, I guarantee it. I'm going to probably hear other stories as well. At least 40 of you. I am so sorry. But we are going to, my group here, all of us that hang together and watch my videos, and I just look at us as like one nice big RV family. We're going to figure this out. We're going to figure this out because we did not get into RVing to be subjected to this craziness. And I'm saying that a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but not really. I got into RVing with my wife Yoko because we wanted a place, we wanted a refuge, we wanted someplace we could go that is away from everything else, peaceful, quiet, and we did not get into it to have barking dogs, families pulling up at all hours of the night making noise, kids running across. We didn't get into it for that reason. So there is a solution. We're going to come up with it. I was talking to Outdoor Nomad a short time ago, and he told me actually right around, not far from here in Utah, there are plenty of places to go. You just go out, way out in the middle of nowhere, and there are roads, and there are pull-offs, and you can just, there are people that just camp on these kind of like out-of-the-way roads and canyons on pull-offs. And Yoko and I would probably love to do that. But watch, just our luck, we'll do it, and some RV will come pulling up right next to us with 20 grandkids coming out of the back. Who knows? I'm not wishing that on myself or you because we don't want that to happen. Unless, of course, you're the one with 20 grandkids running all over the place, wild. But if you are, I will ask that you please control your kids or grandkids or groups or families or dogs and music and smoking or whatever it might be. Be considerate, be kind, because there are people like us that like to be peaceful and quiet and considerate to others. To the 40 of you that I jinxed, I'm humbly sorry. If there's any way I can repay you, let me know. I will take care of you. I promise. Until next time, I am the RV Dummy. See you later.